How to use Google Meet. If you're looking to use Google Meet for video conferencing, it's a super easy platform to use. To begin using Google Meet, you can either go to meet.google.com, or when you're logged into your Google account, you can select the grid in the top right corner for more Google Apps, and then find the Meet app. Once you're on the Google Meet homepage, you have a few options as to how you can use Google Meet. In the bottom left corner, you can choose to start a meeting, enter a meeting code if somebody else has invited you to join a meeting, or you can schedule a meeting from your Google Calendar. We're going to start this tutorial by going through how to start a meeting. So click Start a Meeting. And Google Meet gives you a preview of how your screen will appear prior to joining the meeting. You have the option of turning your camera on or off by selecting the camera icon. And if you want to turn your microphone off, you can select the microphone icon as well. On the right-hand side here, you have the options to join now or present. If you're looking to join the meeting automatically sharing your screen, you can select present. But you can also get into that later and we'll show you how. So if you're ready to join the meeting, select Join Now. Automatically, Google Meet presents you with a pop-up where you can invite others to join your meeting. There's two ways to invite people to join a meeting. The first is by copying the joining info, which is the Google Meet link and other information that they can use. If you select Copy Joining Info, you can then paste the information into your own email draft or meeting invite. Alternatively, you can select Add People and then enter the name or email address of the people you'd like to invite, and they'll receive an auto-generated email from Google Meet to invite them. Once your meeting is taking place, there's a few options and commands that you have within your meeting screen. First, in the bottom left-hand corner is Meeting Details. If you select this, you can once again copy your joining info to share with others so that they can also join the meeting. The second tab under Meeting Details is Attachments. This is a super useful capability that Google Meet offers. If you schedule a Google Meet with a Google Calendar invite and decide to add an attachment to the meeting invite, those attachments will appear under this tab. It makes it really easy to reference and limits people having to go back and forth between the meeting invite and their Google Meet. On the bottom right-hand side of the screen, you have a few other options. The first option is to turn on your captions. This allows you to transcribe your meeting for accessibility or for taking notes. Beside captions, you have the option to present now. This is where you can go to share your screen with fellow attendees in the meeting. You have the option to share your entire screen if you want to switch between windows and different documents. You can share an entire window on your desktop, which is helpful when you're sharing different content on different tabs in a browser. Or you can select to share a specific Chrome tab. Once you have the option that you'd like to use, click it. You can then select which window or tab you'd like to share. We're going to share the YouTube video that we have open in another tab, so we're going to select that. In the bottom left corner here, you'll see an option to share audio. For video specifically, you want to make sure that that's checked off so that the sound of your video will also be shared. Once you have everything selected, click Share. As you can see at the top of your screen, Google reminds you that you're sharing this tab in Google Meet, and if you want to stop sharing, you can click Stop. If you go back to your Google Meet tab, you'll be reminded once again that you're presenting to everyone. In the top right corner of the screen, you'll see a presentation tile, and if you click this, you can view what others are seeing on their own screens. By clicking this tile, you also pin this view, which means people will be forced to view this screen. If you select your profile icon in the top right corner, you'll have pinned the camera to yourself, which means that even though you're still sharing your screen, you'll be forced to view your camera. You can also pin other attendees by selecting their own tiles. This is helpful for presentations if you're going to be switching between your shared screen and your own camera without having to stop sharing your screen entirely. Once you're ready to stop sharing, just click Stop Presenting. You can access more options and capabilities in Google Meet by selecting the More Options icon in the bottom right corner of the screen. Here you can change the layout of your screen. By selecting Auto, Google Meet will choose the layout that is most appropriate to how many attendees you have in the meeting. Sidebar allows you to have a spotlight on one attendee, but to also see your fellow attendees on the right-hand side. The spotlight option only shows one attendee at a time, and tiled allows you to see multiple people at one time. Under More Options, you also have the ability to switch to full screen, turn on your captions as well, and select Settings, which is where you can edit your audio and video capabilities. In the top right corner of the screen, you can engage further with the attendees in your meeting. By selecting the user icon, you can view everybody in the meeting and they'll be listed below here. You can once again add people to the meeting by selecting Add People and then entering their name or email address. And finally, you can click Chat to chat with the other attendees in the meeting. Last but not least, in the bottom center of your screen, you can once again mute or unmute your microphone, enable or disable your camera, and if you want to end the call, select the phone icon to leave the call. If you go back to the Google Meet homepage and you decide that you want to schedule a meeting for a later date, you can select Schedule a Video Meeting with Google Calendar. And this automatically opens up a meeting invite with Google Calendar. You can enter your details as you would for a normal meeting, but as you can see here, Google Meet has already created a meeting link that attendees can click to join the meeting. If you were to go to your Google Calendar and create a new meeting, you can also select to add a Google Meet video conferencing to the meeting by selecting the button in the meeting details. And that's how to use Google Meet. If this video helped you, let us know by liking it or commenting below. And don't forget to subscribe for more how-to instructional videos.